Le spectacle des Backstreet Boys.
The latest new sensation, the Backstreet Boys.
The Backstreet Boys.
The Backstreet Boys.
The Backstreet Boys. The Backstreet Boys. The
Backstreet Boys.
TV, thank you, and we can't forget all of you out there who voted for us. We love you. Oh, 62 times a week. Here, AJ, Howie, Nick, Brian, and Kevin. AJ? Kevin? Nick? Howie?
Hello.
Congratulations. Nice to see you guys in America. It's great to be here. And we have some plaques that we wanted to bring up and give to you guys. One plaque certifying 2.5 million albums shipped around the world in store today. And
that's great.
And that's just the start, by the way. We have the numbers. We left the space open for how many units, because by tonight and tomorrow, we're going to be changing these numbers. It's kind of like the Jerry Lewis telethon. You know, we're going to have the big tote board. This is for 2.5 million albums shipped, and the gold single of Quit Playing Games in America here. So,
thank y'all.
Thank you.
Rock, I got yours, Rock.
You got mine? You can hold all of them.
Nou, je ziet, ze zijn er eindelijk. En voordat je gelijk alleen maar gillend voor de televisie zit, ze hebben dus net allerlei platina en gouden platen uitgekregen. In eerste instantie een gouden plaat voor de single Quit Playing Games. Die is in Amerika inmiddels goud. En wereldwijd hebben ze al meer dan 2,5 miljoen exemplaren van het nieuwe album verkocht. Dus ook daar kunnen ze al gelijk allerlei platen voor verwachten. Dus dit is even... Howie B heeft zijn haar lang. Naar achteren vind ik toch leuker. Nou goed, in ieder geval is het nu even tijd om de foto's te maken. En zometeen zullen ze ongetwijfeld beginnen. Gaan ze eerst rustig zitten en beginnen met het vragen stellen vanuit de zaal van zowel fans als de journalisten. Dat is altijd weer een heel apart spektakel hoe dat gaat. Dan moet je weer netjes je vinger opsteken, vertellen van welk station je bent, of van welk blad je bent, of van welk radiostation je bent. En dan rustig je vraag stellen.
You should get another one of the small ones.
Left.
The left over here?
Yes.
Where do we look? I'll be blind.
Wow, that's a lot of flashes.
Back middle.
Backstreet Boys dus in Londen in het All Star Café.
New York.
In New York, of course. In het All Star Café. En dat ligt op Times Square. Of dat zit op Times Square. En voor degenen die nog nooit in Amerika geweest zijn, zoals ik, schijnt dat daar dus ook oud en nieuw echt heel uitbundig gevierd wordt. En dat daar ook al die neonlichten en theaters zitten. Dus ik denk dat het daar ook behoorlijk druk op dit moment zal zijn. En het is nog steeds tijd voor foto's.
Check. We just want to say something really quickly. We see a lot of familiar faces out in the audience from all over the world that we've seen doing promotional tours. People from everywhere, all media, all over the world. It's good to be back here in the United States doing our first big press conference here. And we want to apologize for being a little late. One thing that we've learned the past 3 years that in the entertainment industry, not everything goes according to schedule. So we were downstairs making sure everything was going to sound okay for the show. Now let's begin the press conference.
Let's do it.
I'm Kevin.
I'm AJ.
I'm Nick.
I'm Howie D.
And I'm Brian.
And together we're the
Backstreet Boys.
Now we check one through.
Sounds like a familiar ID.
Your problems there down in Orlando when you collapsed on the set. Can you just talk a little bit about this, because they were very worried about you and about the tour?
First of all, I didn't collapse, which was a good thing. It was very hot in the rehearsal hall, and I was getting really exhausted. And I went to the doctor, and he told me to take a few days off, you know, just to rest. And that's what I did. Yes, I'm fine now.
Hey fellas, Rick the Temp from Much Music right here in Canada.
Hey, what's up?
How you doing? You guys take great direction, by the way. I just want to start off by saying you've been together for almost 4 years, every day together.
Almost five.
Almost five. With each other. What bugs you about each other? Is there something? Is it smelly socks? Is it something after a gig?
We know each other's buttons to push, that's for sure.
I know.
Definitely.
But we're like brothers. I mean, we all know the right buttons to push to make each other mad or to have fun with each other. I mean, we're just like a family, you know? Yeah. So.
And we've been watching up in Canada for a few years now, and I've been watching it especially, and I think I got what it takes to be a Backstreet Boy. What do you think?
Well, can you sing?
Can you dance?
I can move. I can shake. And
but can you sing?
Can you sing?
That's the question. Yeah, I don't think they want to hear that.
You got a mic? Go right ahead.
Go ahead. You got a mic?
Quit playing games with my heart.
Quit playing games with my heart.
He's got it.
Oh, yeah.
But it really goes like this. It really goes like this. Quit playing games with my heart. My heart. My heart.
This is the album.
I should have known from the start. My heart. My heart.
Last one.
My heart.
That's a little acapella.
Thank you for the bird. How much? Going.
That's a little acapella rendition of it.
I want to say something really quick, which is towards Jive Records and all the producers that worked with us on our first U.S. album. Thank you guys for all your support. It was a pleasure working with all the producers. We worked with some wonderful, wonderful producers. Timmy Allen, Full Force, a couple of fellas over there to the right. What's up, fellas? Dennis Pop and Max Martin. Wonderful people, Mutt Lang. And hopefully for many albums to come, we'll get to work with these guys again, and it'll just be continuous success for all of us. So thank you guys for all your support. We appreciate it. Right.
Do we have any more questions for the Backstreet Boys? Anybody have their hand raised? They'd be love to answer some questions. Let's go way over here.
Yes, sir.
We'll get a microphone to you. We'll take care of you.
Hold up. His name is Chris.
State your name.
Yeah. Chris Cann from Hot 103.5 in Toronto. Right now, we got thousands and thousands of fans, guys, waiting on your every word downtown Toronto, okay?
Oh, wow.
Yeah, honestly, just give them a little wave.
Hey!
What's up, Toronto?
Perfect, right on.
Looking forward to coming back.
I want to put you on the spot. When are you guys coming back to Toronto?
We're coming back to Canada right after Christmas, the 26th, the day after Christmas. We're going to do a couple shows in Canada, and we're going to celebrate New Year's, actually, in Montreal.
So. Right on. Right on. Woo! You guys have got great support worldwide. Of course, it started in most of it in Canada. They've been great with you guys. Of course, Diamond Status on your video. What do you think of Canadian fans? What do you think of fans worldwide, but especially Canada?
We love the fans. I mean, the fans is what makes the Backstreet Boys who we are. We have a lot of dedicated fans all around the world that have been there for the support of us for the last 18 months which we've been on tour. And like I say, without the fans, it wouldn't be the Backstreet Boys. Especially
right on,
the Canadian fans, the European fans, the Orient fans,
and
now the American fans, hopefully.
I forget about five of them.
So what's it like, guys? I mean, you have, you know, this big thing happening in Europe. It's happening now in America. Is it like juggling two girlfriends? I mean, like, you got to make sure everyone is happy. I mean, is it crazy for you?
Well, definitely now getting to every place that wants to see a show and making sure we spread ourselves around evenly is going to be a challenge, especially with the way things are going here in the U.S. now. Our time is few and far between right now. We have little time to do hardly anything, so we're just going to have to concentrate and make sure we spread ourselves around the right way.
Any more questions for the Backstreet Boys? I know there are several out there. Let's go. You pick it, Darren. We're going to go way over here. State your name, please, if you would.
I'm Maya from Bravo, Spain. You had to cancel your visit to Ibiza 2 weeks ago. What are your plans about Spain? Are you coming back again, or what's up?
Definitely have it on the schedule again. Spain and South America is a big market for us, Latin market.
Yeah, but when are you coming back to Spain?
I think I saw on the schedule sometime before the end of this year.
That's it, exactly. November 5th.
Exactly.
November 5th.
Just told ourselves.
Now, as you know, we're on in Berlin right now. Say hi to Germany, everybody.
Hi, Germany.
And 600 screaming Backstreet Boys fans there celebrating Backstreet's back. And they, Sandra Shade, 17 years old, had a question all the way from Berlin. What are you most looking forward to about the forthcoming tour?
Definitely performing the new material and on a new stage. We're going to have pyro this time, so that's going to be interesting. We're going to have pyro, lots of special effects, new band members. So just getting back in front of our fans in Germany and playing under the stars for the first time.
So is the show different in America than it is in Germany?
Yes.
Yeah.
It is.
About 30,000 to 50,000 people, hopefully. So this sold out tour, I heard. So just for now, it's a little bit different, the amount of fans, but hopefully in America, we'll be able to do that soon.
So I understand we have another question way over there. If you can stand up, please. Thanks.
Hi, guys, again. Mike Gauthier, Musique Plus, Montreal. They are actually presently 2,000 people in the Spectrum seeing this press conference.
Hello, Montreal. Hello, Montreal.
What's up? You recorded the Quit Playing Games, I think, in Spanish. Can we expect to hear the Backstreet Boys singing in French because you're so popular in Quebec and in many French-speaking countries?
Actually, it was I'll Never Break Your Heart, and I'd go anywhere for you. Sorry. That's in Spanish. But yeah, we're trying to incorporate as much in the language. Spanish has been the first because I'm part Spanish. And, we have a lot of different heritages in us. So I guess within time, hopefully, we'll try to cover a little bit of each language. But right now, English is our main spoken language. Okay. So.
And did you have to move from Orlando, or are you still based in Orlando, Florida?
Still based there.
But now with the success of the album or your songs, how will you face it? The success in your own city.
Very carefully. Very, very carefully.
Whose idea was it for Quit Playing Games for the video? Who said, let's put water all over you and make you look all hot and steamy?
We actually, the director submitted a treatment for that. And as soon as we saw the water, we thought it would be cool. We thought it would be sort of artsy, sort of, I don't know, something different.
Different.
Something
definitely
that hasn't been out there.
Cool. Another question here. You, sir.
My name's Aubrey Rubin. I'm from Manchester, England. Now, you've been a big hit in England. Did you play Manchester when you were on that tour?
Yes, we did.
Are you going back to Manchester?
We're going to get back. What we want to do is sometime around the first of next year, we'd like to put together a tour, either the first or middle of next year. We'd like to just do a world tour around the whole world. So we won't have to keep switching our shows, because right now we have two different shows. We have a show that we're going to do here in the States, and we have a show that we do everywhere else internationally.
We just got finished with performing here in Wembley Arena.
Last thing. I'm the entertainment editor for Temas magazine. That's the oldest Spanish magazine in New York, 47 years old, a little older than I am. But I want to ask you, you said that you sung in Spanish and you're part Spanish. Mm-hmm. Your mother was Spanish?
Yes,
my mother's Spanish. Do you speak Spanish?
Yo hablo un poco Spanish.
Any other Spanish? What? Any other Spanish influence among the other members of the...
Yo estudio español en la escuela dos años.
Bien. Que bien. See, it pays to study Spanish.
Yes, definitely.
I understand you got a good piece of advice from a member of the Temptations, huh?
Definitely. We were fortunate enough to get to go backstage and meet the Temptations when they were in Orlando doing a show. We actually sang for the guys, and after we got done singing, they said, you guys are really talented and we think you're going to go far, but just remember this little piece of advice. We got two words here. There's show and business. And just make sure while you're out on the stage doing your show, somebody's watching your business for you.
Right. Very well put. We have another question here.
Hi, guys. My name is Nora Hernandez from Eres Magazine, Mexico. Are you planning to visit Mexico? Have you ever been there?
Yes, we are.
Yeah?
We already planned to visit Mexico one time before, but something came up and we had to shoot three videos for the upcoming album. So we're going to get back down there as soon as possible. Like I say, our record company and our management are right now carefully planning out this next year, because it's going to be a busy one for us. So we're just going to try to get everywhere.
Do you have any date exactly?
Not as of right now.
Not. And do you want to sing in Spanish to record a disc in Spanish?
Do we want to record some more in Spanish?
Yeah.
Definitely.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome.
You guys have time for a personal life at all? Any girlfriends?
Not much. I mean,
yeah.
we date around.
We're dating.
Nobody can really put up with our schedules right now.
We have another question over here, Darren, from Canada.
Bonjour.
I just want to, on behalf of all the fans in Quebec, first of all, congratulate you for the success that you know worldwide. I just want to ask you, what would be the most important thing for the American audiences to know about the Backstreet Boys? What do you want to get out there first before anything else gets out there about you guys?
And we're a vocal harmony group, and we're not just a boy group.
We're real.
This is the Backstreet Boys. We're all about putting out good music. It's all legit. And we're here to hopefully stay for a while.
We've been fortunate to see the fact that your families are all very important, and those values that come from family are very, very imperative to you all. I understand that on the U.S. album, though, your thank yous have somewhat been omitted, so I want to know if you want to say something to your families in front of your American audiences for the very first time.
Just that we love you, and we thank you for always sticking behind us and supporting us.
We tried to squeeze in as many names as we could on the credits there.
Hi, Mom!
Sorry, we didn't get everybody.
Hi, Mom.
Thank you.
Hi, Grandma.
You know who you are.
Also, reconfirm to the fans in Germany and Europe that you love them, because they're fearful now that you're blowing up here in America, that you're going to forget all about them.
We're not going to forget about our fans who found us first. We appreciate our fans all over the world who discovered our music first, and we're not going to forget about you. Right now, I mean, a lot's going on. We're being cybercast, we're being simulcast, and we're being satellited all over the world right now. So, hello to everyone out there.
Hello, hola, the gates. Bonjour.
Any more questions? Where is the microphone?
There we go.
Right here. This guy's been up front for a while.
Hi, I'm Roy Frederick with the SJS Radio Network. It was mentioned just now about family values. Do you have something to say to the kids out there, your fans out there, about who are being pressured now by their friends and peer groups about to possibly use something that they shouldn't be using, which is drugs?
Something that we want to make clear from the beginning is that none of us up here are perfect, and we don't profess to be perfect. We've just been raised by families that brought us up with certain values, and we don't try to preach that to other people. We don't try to say that, you know, we are perfect, but we just try to be a good influence, and we just want everybody to, before they do anything, to always think and be responsible. Being in the public eye, we have a lot of pressure put on us to be role models, because a lot of young people look up to us. So, you know, before we do certain things, we just have to think before we do them and realize what effect it might have on our lives and our careers. And that's the advice we give to everybody. Just think before you do anything, because, you know, it has consequences.
I think as being, people put us a lot of time in the past of being a role model, and we always try to tell people we're not role models. We think a lot of times the limelight is put on entertainers and, you know, basketball stars to be role models. We feel like the role models should come within the family, your mothers and fathers and the teachers. And that's where you should look up to.
I believe we have another question right over here. Standing by.
Hey, my name is John Ryan. I'm from Nickelodeon Magazine, across the street. And thanks. We were wondering what you're doing for Thanksgiving this year and what your favorite part of the turkey is.
actually, we have the day off before Thanksgiving, so hopefully we can get back and see our families and actually spend the day of Thanksgiving. I like the legs the most.
Yeah,
dark
legs.
Meat.
I like the legs.
Try
legs.
To watch a football game. I'm a lean man. I like the breast.
Oh!
All right, Darren, you can get over there and get another question over there. Now, I understand, do you guys still do covers anymore when you're doing a show? Will you still do, like, Shy If I Ever Fall in Love? You did? Yep. Any new covers we can expect if you're performing?
Well, actually, we did a cover on the album of P.M. Dawn's.
Oh, Set Adrift from Memory
Set
Bliss.
Set Adrift,
which is a great song.
Yeah.
Fabulous. You guys did a great job at doing that. Now, is that on the Backstreet's Back CD as well?
Yes, it is.
Okay, so it's on both.
Yes.
Cool. Another question. I know I feel bad you guys had to keep moving your heads tonight. You have whiplash, and we're going to go over the show later on.
How you doing? Magic Eddie Mills from Edmonton, Canada, Power 92, the first station in Western Canada to put you guys on the air.
Thank you so much.
And a lot of folks have fans, and even the guys at the radio station have been saying, make sure you find out. You know they're going on another tour. You mentioned December 26th. You kick off a few Canadian dates. What have you got for Western Canada?
We haven't set up any dates around Christmas. We're going to be, can't think of the place that we haven't been before yet.
Halifax, man. We're going to go way up in there.
Thank you.
We haven't been there yet. We're going to go up there. We're going to be in Montreal and Toronto. But we're not going to go out west when we're up there for Christmas. Possibly a couple months.
You'll be back, though. Yeah. Right? Excellent. And I got to say, Pam Stevens is also here from Western Canada, Z95 Vancouver. You want to say something?
We're hogging the mics now. I actually ran into Kevin and AJ on the street the other night in Times Square with some listeners that we brought out. Right. And one thing that you guys probably don't realize, I mean, you see them scream and you see them get excited. When you guys were last in Vancouver, part of a Make-A-Wish Foundation brought a young woman backstage to meet you. Her cousin is a listener of ours who has been in contact with me. She got a letter to me. I figured it might not get to you if I got it through the label, whatever. Part of what she wanted, her dream at that point was to live to see her 14th birthday to meet the Backstreet Boys. She got backstage, she saw you, she passed away on her 14th birthday. Her family just wanted to say thank you so much for giving her that to live for and that, you know, the hope, the happiness that they all had to hold on to for that amount of time. Any other stories like that? What are you guys reaching? What do you get from your fans? I didn't mean to bring it all down like that, but I just really wanted, these girls in this family were just so touched by it, and it was very important to them that they got to hear that.
I think if there's any time we can ever touch anybody's lives like that, with our music, with our presence, it means a lot to us. We try to do as many charity events as possible. Over in Europe, we've done a lot of events for cancer. We try to visit children's hospitals. And that means a lot to us because, you know, as being an entertainer, we have a lot of dedicated fans. We like to give something back. So whenever we can do certain things like that, it means a lot to us.
We have another question over here.
Dave Langell from The Net on Radio 1 in the United Kingdom. You've had a lot of success in the United Kingdom, and we're just wondering how you feel to be top 10 in America now.
Feels excited. It feels really good. I mean, we've been overseas for the last year and a half now and been waiting patiently and patiently every day to come back home and bring our success back home. And hopefully with this first album, things will move as smoothly as they did for us over in Europe. And we're keeping our fingers crossed, and with the support from our fans and friends and families, hopefully we'll do it again here.
And the timing, you know, I'm over here, sorry to do this to you. The timing is perfect, too, because don't you think the music has changed in America compared to 2 years ago? We were all rocking out. It was grunge, grunge, grunge. Now, just pure pop music is back in America, and you guys are the perfect fit.
Yeah, I think just general feel-good, good music that makes everybody sing along, and that's what we're trying to do.
Great. Another question over here.
Hi, it's Sam from YTV. How are you?
Good, how are you doing?
Do you guys know that a lot of fans have driven down from Canada or even flown down just to be with you here today to celebrate?
Heard, yeah. Yeah.
So if you could say a few words to them, because they might even be watching downstairs on a big screen, that would mean a lot to them.
Well, wait, hang on. Nick, why don't you say something?
Yeah, come on.
What?
No, I guess I can say this. This is in French. Je t'aime.
Oh, merci beaucoup.
But it's true. We do.
And if you could say hi to all the fans in Toronto and Montreal.
Oh, yeah.
Or in Canada watching, because Canadian fans are worried that, you know, you might forget us, even though we're happy to share you with the rest of the world.
We want to come back to the Maple Leaf Garden.
Woo!
That'd be cool.
Okay, and definitely. One more question, Nick. Your younger brother, Aaron, is going to be touring with you in Europe. Are you bringing him to Canada as well when you come in December?
Who knows? I mean, he's just doing his own thing right now. In Germany and Europe, so I mean, who knows?
Well, we'd like to see him.
That'd be cool.
Thanks.
So some people have compared you to, hey, they're the male version of the Spice Girls. People have actually said that. What is your comment on that?
Well, a lot of people who haven't heard of us before think we just popped up out of nowhere, but we've been around. We've been together now for almost 5 years, so. We've done a few shows with the Spice Girls, and I think we're pretty different than they are.
Yeah.
our music, we have a lot of R&B influence in our music, a lot of soul and R&B influence in our music, and I think that shows.
The one thing about your album, too, it's not just one sound. You got ballads, you got pure dance music, you got it all.
And we're trying to do a little bit of everything.
Exactly. Question, we're getting further back. That's perfect. I'm glad we're getting back there.
Hello, I'm fucking Lucky.
And I am Tony Aguilar. And together we are from...
Los 40 Principales.
In Spain.
Yeah. Well, congratulations, because this is the first time in the story of the market in Spain one artist becomes 4 times platinum for the first album and the same day, today or yesterday, platinum and a half of the new record. It's the first time. Not the Beatles.
Yes.
But, well... Congratulations.
Gracias.
But, thank you for your support to the Spanish people here in Spain. But why New York and not Miami or LA to make this?
Well, our record company is based here. This is where we were signed, up here in New York. And I just got to untie my tongue today. Yeah. If you can make it here, you can make it anywhere. So that's why we had it here.
We have a question right over here.
Don McLaughlin from the 60 Second CD. When you were breaking abroad for a while now, was there any concern, any anxiety that you wouldn't make it here, or did you think that American success was inevitable?
I don't think so. I think it was a matter of just the timing for us. When we came out with our first single, We've Got It Going On, about 2 years ago, we released it here, and it did well on the charts. Like I say, it exploded over in Europe and the rest of the world. So we just, at that time, we felt like, well, the time in the music was really like grunge and rap and stuff like that. And we said, well, we figured that America wasn't exactly ready for a group like us. So we went to the areas where they were, you know, welcoming us. And we kind of, you know, by popular demand, we stayed over there for the last 18 months. But now, like I say, since the music has changed a little bit and pop music is really coming back to the scene, we feel like, you know, we should be able to hit it strong here and dedicate a lot of time.
Have you guys, by the way, kept count of how many photo shoots, interviews, hotel check-ins, sound checks, and bus rides you've been on?
No.
It's amazing. I heard 57 shows in 48 days. Is that right? You did that one time?
That was our first tour.
First tour.
First headlining tour in Germany, Austria, and Switzerland.
And no burnout. You made it.
We made it.
No cancellation.
It's rough. It's hard. The road life is hard.
We're on number 4 now, on our 4th tour now, so...
I believe we have a question from the fan here.
Hi, Celeste Balducci Chapin and with Claire and Genevieve, your biggest fans out of Jackson Heights, New York.
Oh, thanks.
Thanks for coming to New York.
Thanks for coming.
And Genevieve wanted to know how you guys met, how it all started.
Actually, myself, AJ, Nick, we met about, good lordy, about 7 years ago. And we were just friends. We met each other through acting. We did a lot of auditions together at Universal Studios, MGM Studios in Orlando. And we also found that we had another passion, which was music, singing. So we put a little trio together, and we presented it to a record label in Orlando called Transcontinental Records. And Lou Pearlman, the president of the label, kind of took us under his wing. And we decided at that time that we wanted to go to a major label to get, you know, worldwide distribution and everything. So, but at that time, we wanted to add some more members to the group to make the harmonies richer. So we met Kevin, who was working at Disney at the time. And Kevin then brought us his cousin Brian from Kentucky. And we've been together 4.5 years now, and it's history.
When you guys got together, who was out at the moment that really inspired you? Like Call Me Bad.
Shy. Call Me Bad. Jealousy. Boyz II Men.
Have you had the privilege to meet Boyz II Men?
Yeah, we met Boyz II
Men. Three out of four. Basketball game.
Another question right here.
Kirby Moreau from Flash in Montreal. Compare your fans from Quebec to the fans all over the world.
Everyone, I mean, aside from the language barrier, people are really people. I mean, there's not much of a real difference. We haven't really done that much in the U.S. yet to really compare the fans, but hopefully when we do our tour coming up in September, we'll get a little bit of a taste of the U.S. fans, and then we can let you know then.
But what's your best souvenir of Montreal? You've been there a lot.
Montreal is a really nice, I feel, is a really nice mixture culture-wise of Europe and the U.S. sort of combined. That's what it
is. And Kevin, what were you doing at midnight at Times Square last night?
I was going to have a bite to eat with my brother who came up to check out the press conference. And you caught me out on the street. I did an interview for you, so be nice to me.
Thank you for the interview, eh?
Is that strange when you're going out? You're like, well, I better not walk into that store. They might be watching me.
Sometimes. Especially when we're overseas. with the popularity. You just have to plan what you want to do a little carefully. Make sure that security knows where you are at all times, and you know, just plan things right. If you don't want to be noticed, you can sort of hide.
Yeah.
Right. You can do
right.
it.
Put the mask on there.
Yeah.
The Richard Nixon mask on. All right. Go ahead, Darren.
Redo Radio 24 Switzerland. Could you tell us something about your new tour, something about your open air tour through Europe?
Oh, geez. We have a six-piece band. Show runs about, an hour and 45 minutes?
Almost. An hour 45.
Yeah, about an hour and 45 minutes. We basically do almost every song off the new album, as well as some of the hits from the old album. And, I mean, we got a bunch of new surprises for you guys. We're trying to keep it a big hush-hush because we want to surprise everybody, but going to be better than the last tour.
These
hopefully.
Will be the biggest audiences we've ever performed in front of.
It's going to be a lot of fun.
20 to 50,000 people outside under the stars. We can't wait. It's going to be incredible.
Thank you.
Is it weird to come back to America and it's like you're an upstart band all over again and you have to...
Oh, yeah. I mean,
very humble. Yeah.
After selling out the Molson Center three nights in a row and then coming back to the U.S. and performing in parking lots... It's an adjustment, but it's very humbling, and we don't mind. You know, we're hard workers, and we don't mind.
Plus, you know, it's just a matter of time before you're selling out giant stadium here, you know,
we'll
across the river.
We'll
another question.
Hi, we're Alexandra and Lonnie from Amsterdam, Holland. We want to know, the fans in Holland are watching, too. Could you say something
Hello,
to
Holland.
Them?
Hey. Hello, Holland.
And when are you guys coming to Holland again? That's what we want to know.
We're just there.
Where's our booking agent right now?
We're just there.
David,
we need a travel agent up here.
Hardcore
in March.
Fans
right here, March.
March.
They're hardcore fans in Holland. Come on, guys.
March.
March. We'll be there.
March.
Agent.
There, March. Okay. Dave Zedek, promoter.
Do you have a favorite place? Or can you play favoritism here?
Oh, if we were to say a favorite place, we'd probably get beaten up and thrown out.
Absolutely.
And we
Every
all
place.
Have our places that we like.
We're live at the official All-Star Cafe. Paul Cubby Bryant from Z100 Radio, the Backstreet Boys, if you just tuned in, worldwide. And we have another question right over here.
Yes, hello, guys. Didy Fortin from Sequoia, Montreal.
Hey.
We know each other. Question for Brian. I think you wrote your first song on the new album. Is that right?
Yes.
And it's a song about?
It's a song entitled That's What She Said. I wrote it on our, not the last tour that we did, but the tour before that in Europe. And... it's not really about a specific person or a specific experience. I mean, it's a love song. It's about promises, about things that you say that never come true. It just came together. I was on tour. I got with our pianist and our guitarist from our band. I already had the melody in my head, the whole song. We put it together. The guys helped me in the studio when we got home. We finally got a chance to do some of our own material because we've been so busy all the time, so I got to be the lucky one to have a first song on the album, so I'm very fortunate. I hope everybody likes it.
I'm sure they'll like it. And we're anxious to see you back in Montreal.
Thank you.
Well, the Backstreet Boys, I just got word in my earpiece, are getting ready to do their big performance at Virgin Megastore right next door here in New York City, so let's
see
give a big
there.
Round of applause to the Backstreet Boys.
Please. Thank you.
Thanks to the official All-Star Cafe. Z100 New York City, and thank you the
you,
world.
Thank you, Z100. Thank you, New
thank
York.
Thank you.
Over the world, on the radio, on the TV, let them hear you. Paul Cubby Bryant from Z100 New York City.